Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And here I'm going to elaborate the celestial world, ecclesiastical world, sorry, the second word, ecclesiastical. And ecclesiastical world is called PARLOK. Par mean away, lok means secular, away from the secular world. ARSHI DUNIYIA, in Urdu they call it ARSHI DUNIYIA, spiritual world. It is for souls. You remember that our secular world is for bodies and this ecclesiastical world is for our souls. It is for souls confined in bodies, our secular bodies, but for identification of souls. The souls have, you know, the names of the body shall have to be mentioned. You know, the souls, they don't have identity. You can't say, put a name to the soul. Name has to be given to body. Same, Jesus was the name of his body and Christ was within him. So Christ cannot be seen or named. So that's why he was called Christ Jesus. So Christ was his title. Jesus was the name, physical body. It is of no limitation. Can be located and named after the function and in whose memory it is built. You know, we have these spiritual spiritual world or ecclesiastical has three communities. For the moral laws, which are the mandirs, temples, synagogues, and then second one is for the spiritual principle, learning spiritual principle, gospel, which are churches, gurdwaras, mosques you can go, and so and so. And in whose memory it is built, then they are named after the memory, you know, built in the saint, in the name of Paul, Christ Paul, they call it Saint Paul, you know, but he was Christ, Christ Thomas, and so, it is the Pope who changed their name, you know, to Saint, but they were Christ when they were given their wage at Pentecost. They all got the Holy Spirit, the very Spirit of God, and they became the twin brethren of Christ Jesus. Christ Jesus, he was not a saint. His title was Christ, and so is the title of all those apostles who were given their wage at Pentecost. They are all Christ. In Jesus, we are Christ with small c, not Christian. Christians are people of the book. So it is changeable. That means you can change it, you know. Say from a mandir, you can make it a gurdwara, or from a church, you can make another thing. It is never the personal property of any person, you know, it's a communal property. It's a, of a community, it's not somebody's personal as you know it, you know. Its in charge is nominated or elected. So the one who had the ecclesiastical community, whether it is the first ecclesiastical community, which is Hindu, which is the same as Judaism, or so and so, where the moral education is given. So the rabbi is the one who is by hereditary, because this job is given to people of certain tribes. In India, it is given to more than one tribe, but in the Middle East, it is given only to the Levi tribe. Only they can become a rabbi and then perform the duties of a Kohen, which is same as Brahman in India. Kohen and Brahman, similar thing. According to the religious qualifications, there are three communities. So again, I can explain them on the basis of this table which I presented. So you have three communities. So you have, this one is the first community for children where you learn moral laws. This is called Hindu Panth or Samaj or Judaism. This is the spiritual one, when you become sensible by the grace of God and you start understanding spiritual things. To here you learn truth, and here you learn contentment, and here you learn mercy. So this is philanthropic third community, which is of the wise. This is Holy Ghost, Holy Father, Holy Son. This is Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit is different from Holy Ghost. Not many people understand this one. So, for the first community, for those who have a knowledge of first three Vedas. Now, in India, we have Vedas, you know, three Vedas, and we have four Vedas. The fourth one is the oral one. And three Vedas are giving a secular, a social, economical, and political education. So our Vedas are a bit more classified, whereas the written Torah is one book. So we are in Middle East, you have written Torah and oral Torah. In India, you have three Vedas, and fourth one is the oral Torah, Atharva Ved, we call it. For those who have a knowledge of the first three Vedas to teach the moral laws, they are Brahman, you know, pertaining to the body, to secular people for extrinsic values. Extrinsic value mean that society, you know, how they should give their sacrifice for the freedom of their country and everything. So there you have to give the extrinsic value. Nobody is to tell you, you know, what. So this is the Rabbi teaching the moral laws from the written Torah. Now the second community is for those who have a knowledge of four Vedas, the people who, preach gospel, to preach the secular people the spiritual education. Spiritual education is a gospel, oral Torah knowledge. Oral Torah knowledge was given to the people who were sensible, not to the once-born children. So, to realize one's intrinsic values, you know, the spiritual thing is for your own intrinsic value. It's not for your to show off. You have to be humble to realize one's intrinsic value. That is why you need to be a solitary NIYAARA. That means everyone has to make his own effort. You can't uphold your intrinsic value in a group like the one you do in secular one, extrinsic. In extrinsic one, you have to work together in a group. If somebody attacks you, you attack not, you don't defend one by one, you defend all together. And here's the intrinsic values that you have to improve of your own. Not together. So everyone has to make his own effort. And that is why, you know, this is also known that the gospel is received on individual basis, and the gate, narrow gate that leads you to salvation. Only one person passes at a time, not two together. So that is for solitary. We call it NIYAARA in Punjabi. for those who dedicate their lives for philanthropy, that is spiritual rule, that is the third community of philanthropists. Remember that when Jesus was performing deeds of philanthropy, he was doing his spiritual rule over the hearts of the people. When you don't get money, but you do philanthropy, the people thank you from the core of their heart, and that is called spiritual rule. And so was Jesus, our royal king, not on our physical bodies as King David was, but over our hearts. Spiritual rule he was, royal king. But these Jewish people, because they wanted to rule over the other people, they made Jesus a king, secular king, in the line of David. And then the Pope and other people, they start, you know, killing people. But we are in Jesus was a royal king. That is why Christ Jesus was the royal king of the royal kingdom of philanthropy. One who conceals his tribal identity, tribe and residence is not entitled even for the first community. For the second community, only those who are entitled, who speak the truth. Peter, you know, being truthful, he is the rock over which house of God could be built. Peter killed two liars, Annias and Saphira. So no liar is allowed into a church. But today the churches are full of liars. And for the because their priest is employed by Mammon, he worships Mammon and not God. He is the greatest hypocrite in the church. And for the third community, one should be contented too. If you want to be merciful, you have to be a contented person. If you are greedy, then you can't be merciful. Lower community can do service to the higher one. That means people of the first community, where the moral law is taught, they can render service to the second community where the people learn spiritual principles, but cannot join the upper one as a member. So they cannot join the upper one as a member unless they qualify. So there's certain qualifications. The permanent residents of this ecclesiastical world are to be held in respect. It should be, honor, you know. And my father puts respect here. By the secular world, and this ecclesiastical world is to honor the residents of celestial world. So secular people will come to learn in the first two community at fixed hours. So that is what I just gave you a picture again from that thing. Very useful, you know, this Trinity thing. And so this is the first community, second spiritual, this is the moral law. So they should honor the people of this community, but they cannot join this one unless they are truthful. So when they become truthful, only then they can join. And people of this one cannot join this one. They should honor these people. And unless they become contented through his word, they cannot join to this one. So they have to kill greed. Because these people are greedy sometimes by nature. They have to overpower greed and become contented to become merciful people. So these people of this community, they should keep the honor these people of celestial world. These are fakirs, sadhus, apostles, roving preachers, they come in this category. So they should be honored by these two, because they come to teach here, preach here. John the Baptist, he went to wilderness, this one. He was an ideal rabbi. But he went here. That is the situation it should be, but today the world is corrupt. So the things are going the wrong way.